الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره. نعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله سبحانه وتعالى بحبيبه الغمة، وجاهد صلى الله عليه وسلم في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفره إنه كان توابا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وإن خير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من البدع ومن الضلال ومن النار. آمين. All praise and thanks are due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most gracious, the most merciful, the most loving, the most forgiving subhanahu wa ta'ala. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that we worship. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy to be worshipped. He whom ever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, no one else can misguide. And he whom ever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray, no one else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can guide. Peace and the blessings upon our beloved Messenger Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family, his household, his companions, and all Muslims who follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the true way of Islam until the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Dear brothers, sisters, elders, children, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Once again, we meet in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to renew our covenant with him subhanahu, and to clarify our intention and to clean our intention and to purify our intention that we are coming sincerely for him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a ni'mah that needs us to thank him subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. So we say alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. We started speaking about things, if we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us. As Al-Imam Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah rahimahullah explained, also Al-Imam Al-Qayyim, and many of the scholars, they agreed on these things. And they said, first you have Tawheedullah and Tawbah from the Zunub, the Ma'asi, the sins. You make Tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do lots of istighfar. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. You do good deeds, and then when we die, our fellow believers will perform Salat al-Janazah on us. They make dua for us. And also when we go to the grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give us some hasanat and expiate some of the sayyiat, just because us witnessing the questions of the angels when they come and ask us who is our Lord and who is our Prophet and what is our deen. And then we move to Yawm al-Qiyamah. During that day, there will be something that will happen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will still accept our tawbah and will expiate our sins subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is out of rahmatullah. Wa rahmati wasi'at kulla shay. My mercy has encompassed everything. Even after we leave this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still going to forgive us subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we see the Yawm al-Qiyamah, the difficulties, the troubles that will happen there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away some of our sins before he subhanahu wa ta'ala questions us. During that time, there will be some of us getting some helps from the prophets and the angels. The angels will have some kind of shafa'ah. They will intercede for some people. The angels, when they are used to someone praying at night time, reading the Quran, they are always familiar with his voice or her voice during the night time, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will make istighfar for him or her. And on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, they will be shufa'a. They will intercede for these believers with whom they were familiar in dunya with ta'atullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the prophets will get a chance to intercede for some of their followers. But none of the angels and none of the prophets will intercede except when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits. When we read the Quran, we find the ayat of shafa'ah, intercession, only depends on the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who is going to intercede for anyone except with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the permission comes from Allah only for someone whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with to intercede, and someone else whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, so he can accept the intercession of someone to him or to her. So these are conditions of shafa'ah for the angels and the prophets. Allah has to give permission first, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with those who are receiving the shafa'ah and those who are giving the shafa'ah. And as we know, the hadith of shafa'ah, the major hadith, because during that day, the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, one of the best things that you can ever see is shafa'ah to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The big and the most inclusive intercession of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the hadith is sahih from Sayyidina Anas narrates, and he says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the people will be coming on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, they are busy and they are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sun is coming close from the heads. People are sweating. People are busy with their affairs. No father or mother can avail anything for their children, or no children can help their parents. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather everyone. And the people will go to the Prophet, starting from Adam alayhi salam, saying, Adam, you are the first of the creation. Allah created you with his own hands. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put you in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught you the names of everything. Can you come and intercede for us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends that day? And then Adam alayhi salam will say, Nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. I committed some sins that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. And they will go to Nuh alayhi salam, and it will be the same. Nuh alayhi salam will say, Nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself, I cannot go and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry today. I have never seen him subhanahu wa ta'ala angry before like this. And they will go to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, Khalilullah. Oh Ibrahim, you are the best friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you come and intercede? He alayhi salam will say the same. And then they will move to Musa and Isa. And Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam would say, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, I will go and submit myself in sujood under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the arsh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inspire me with some praises and some mahamid that I never knew before. Some du'as that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inspire me that time. And I will say these du'a, these praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will hear the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Muhammad, irfa' ra'saka wa qul tusma' washfa' tushaffa'. Oh Muhammad, raise, come up and say, we will hear to you and introduce your shafa'ah, intercession, and we will accept it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, O Muhammad, go and command the people from your ummah, those who will not see hisab or azab, to go to Jannah directly. No hisab, no azab. As we know, some of this ummah will go directly from the qubur, from the graves, direct to Jannah. They will not see hisab or sirat or anything. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among those who will go to Jannah directly from the graves, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say Muhammad, and they will be also going to the doors of Jannah with other people. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, oh Allah, I ask you, ummati, ummati, my ummah, my ummah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be given the permission to intercede for all Muslims who have been committing sins during their lives, and their a'mal did not make it for them to go to Jannah, and they will get out from Jahannam because of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shafa'ah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this kind of shafa'ah, the intercession of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have to be eligible for it. And the only condition, and the main and the major condition, is to live on La ilaha illallah Muhammadu Rasulullah, and to die on La ilaha illallah Muhammadu Rasulullah, and to be resurrected on La ilaha illallah Muhammadu Rasulullah. If you committed lots of sins and you make tawbah to Allah, you make istighfar and you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshaAllah, bi-idhnillah, you will go to Jannah with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu one day was talking to Sayyidina Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, من أسعد الناس بشفاعتك يوم القيامة. Who is the most happiest person who will receive your intercession on the day of يوم القيامة? Sayyidina Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Aba Huraira, I know that no one will ask me that question before you. I will answer you. The happiest person who will receive my intercession, my shafa'ah on the day of يوم القيامة, whomever say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sincerely from his heart. So this is the shafa'at of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the biggest shafa'ah ever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Out of his love for his ummah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will try to get all the Muslims out of Jahannam just because they said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. During that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know, he created rahmah, mercy, 100 parts. And he only sent one part in this dunya with which we are merciful towards one another. And he kept 99 parts of rahmah to that critical day, day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. So he is going to apply his rahmah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. And then some of the believers, when they go to Jannatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they see the rivers that flows, and they see al-hurul ayn, and they see everything they could never imagine. They will be looking for their friends in dunya, their companions in dunya. And they say, oh Allah, we used to have some friends in dunya. They prayed as we pray. They fasted as we fast. They gave zakah with us, but we don't see them today in Jannah. Where are they? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, my believers, their a'mal didn't make it to Jannah. They are not in Jannah. They are in Jahannam because of their sins, to stay there for some time. And the believers will say, our Lord, can you give us permission to go and help them? And he subhanahu wa ta'ala will give permission to the believers. The believers will have shafa'ah, intercession for their family members and those companions who used to be mu'mins doing good a'mal, but they also used to do some bad deeds and they didn't go to Jannah, but the companionship of the believers will help them. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Al-akhillau yawma'idhin ba'duhum li ba'din aduun illa al-muttaqeen. The close friends in this dunya will become enemies to one another on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. Everybody is busy with themselves except the righteous. The muttaqeen, the believers, they will not be only busy with themselves. They will be busy with those whom they accompanied in dunya. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the permission, and the hadith in Sahih Muslim, they will go to Jahannam, they will find them soaked in the fire. Their bodies almost destroyed. They became ashes. They will be given permission to take them out of Jahannam. In this situation, some ashes, and they will be given permission by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to put them on the bank of the river of life. in Jannah. That is a river called the river of life. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, once they put the ashes of these believers who were in Jahannam, they put them on the banks of the river of life, their bodies will come up from the ground as the seed will sprout out from the ground. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command them, the believers, take their hands and go to my rahmah and go to Jannah. Subhanallah. So look whomever you are befriending. Look at your friend. Is he a good friend or not? Al-Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, when he was speaking about that specific hadith, he said to his students, my students, if you make it to Jannah and you don't find me, please ask about me. Subhanallah. This is Al-Imam Ibn al-Qayyim, one of the pillars of our ulama. He's saying, when he was explaining that hadith, if any of you please make it to Jannah, don't forget about me, ask about me. You can make shafa'ah for me and get me to Jannah. Subhanallah. And after all of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give more shafa'ah to the believers. They will say, oh our Lord, we have some people, they are not yet in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, go to Jannah and go to Jahannam and get out of Jahannam anyone who has in his heart La ilaha illallah, or he has any goodness in his heart as small or as big as one dinar. You know, the dinar is like a coin, $1. If you find anyone in Jahannam who has iman in his heart as small as one dinar, get him out of Jahannam and give him to Jannah. They will go and they get some groups and they say, our Lord, we are done. We got everybody from Jahannam whose heart has one dinar of iman. Allah will say, go again and get anyone out of Jahannam who has iman in their heart equal to half of the dinar. They will go again, the mu'mins. Those are the believers. Those are not prophets. Those are not messengers. Those are regular Muslims who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who followed Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who lived on La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah and died on La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, what did you do? They say, we got out everyone who has any iman in their heart as equal to half of the dinar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of his rahmah again will say, go back to Jahannam and get anyone out of Jahannam who has any kind of iman in me as small as a mustard seed. The believers will go back and they will get all who are eligible for this shafa'ah. And finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do something unexpected. After all these people leave Jahannam and go to Jannah, He subhanahu wa ta'ala will take one handful from Jahannam for some Muslims who have never done anything good in their lives except saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and He will send them to Jannah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the day of the surprise. This is the day of shafa'at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shafa'at al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and shafa'at al-mu'mineen. How to be eligible to all this rahmah? To live in la ilaha illallah, and die in la ilaha illallah, and be resurrected with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. وبعد، after all these situations happen, the people of Jannah will go to Jannah, and then a caller will call. All people of Jannah, your Lord has promised you a promise, and He is going to fulfill it today. You come forward for your Lord. And the believers in Jannah will say, our Lord, didn't you forgive our sins? Didn't you push us away from Jahannam? Didn't you admit us to Jannah? You gave us everything. He subhanahu wa ta'ala will come forward. And during that day, the barrier between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be removed. And they will look directly at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَجُوهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. These beautiful faces will be looking at the Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَ. For those who have done good in dunya, الْحُسْنَى which is Jannah, وَزِيَادَ and more, which is seeing the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And seeing Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah is more superior than Jannah itself. subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, today, اليوم أحل عليكم رضواني فلا أسخط عليكم أبدا. Today, I will grant you my pleasure and I will never be angry with you. And this is the utmost happiness that the believers will get in Jannah when they see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they live with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in A'la Aliyin, when they reside in Al-Firdaus Al-A'la min Al-Jannah, just because saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, living on it, acting on it, dying on it, and then seeing Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the day of Qiyam, and following him and his sunnah in dunya, then inshallah we can be accompanied with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in akhirah. So brothers and sisters, this is very real. These are in the Quran and the ahadith that shafa'atul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is there. Shafa'atul mu'mineen, the believers will intercede for each other. And rahmatullah, that has no condition. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala la yus'alu amma yaf'alu wa hum yus'alun. Nobody can ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever he does. He will forgive some people with no reason and they didn't do anything good. But this doesn't carry us out to do some bad deeds and think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just going to forgive. Because when we know that he is Ghafoor Rahim, he is most forgiving, but he is also Shadeedul Iqab subhanahu wa ta'ala. His punishment is severe. We don't want to be eligible for the punishment. We want to be eligible for Jannat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Maghfirat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Rahmat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us eligible for Shafa'at Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to grow the seeds of Iman into our hearts. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to manifest what we believe in into our actions. We ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to help humanity. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna, ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna, ma anta a'lamu bihi minna, anta al-muqaddim wa anta al-mu'akhir wa anta ala kulli shay'in qadir. Ibad Allah, inna Allah ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba, yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar wal baghi ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Fadhkuru Allah yadhkurkum, washkuruhu yaghfir lakum, wa aqimu as-salah.